You had mentioned the student's schedule on paper, sort of looking, you know, taking a comprehensive look at what is the student's day? Is it chopped up into lots of tiny pieces with different specialists and adults and services? When we interviewed Nathaniel Provencio a few months ago, he spoke about, we asked him about the best professional development that he had done. And he said it was taking a stopwatch and following a child for a day and seeing how much meaningful instruction the child had. In this case, it was about 15 minutes in the whole day because the kid was moving from so many different places. And so I think that idea of saying, let's not just look at this little piece that I'm working on, but let's take a look at this child's schedule as a whole and figure out, are there some other ways that maybe we can strategically group? Also, we've worked at Mason Crest, which is a elementary school in Annandale, Virginia. They have been very creative about how they're a professional learning community, so collaboration is embedded in absolutely every element of the school. They actually use all of their adults to work with whatever children need the support. The special education teacher may actually have a reading group that includes some ELLs, some native English speakers, and some struggling readers, and some special education students. Or not. Mm-hmm. And it was very hard, as you can imagine, for the specialists who were used to sort of working with their kids or maybe taking them out and sort of having this focus time to get used to this model. But once they did, it just gave them the flexibility that all the adults were available to help whatever children needed it. And so it's a constant process of reevaluating who's working with what group. Now, clearly that has to be something that comes from every level of because you need the support, but being really creative about saying how can we you know, look at the schedules and look at the time and look at what students need and
that's brilliant. That's because there's so much expertise in our schools, and if we remain kind of in these silos, we're not taking advantage of all the expertise in the school to be able to benefit the students. I think about that. We have social workers who have so much knowledge about, you know, social and emotional well-being and wellness that we can, obviously that social worker can't be treating everyone, but if we can collaborate, we can learn from our colleagues and have that flexibility, then the entire school can be aware of those pieces. Or we have speech-language pathologists who know so much about language development and how to elicit language and generate language, reading specialists. We have all of these colleagues in our buildings. I think that's brilliant to really leverage all those strengths to support the students in a more flexible way. That's wonderful.
Well, we were very intrigued by it as well when we were there.